Hi, and welcome to Around Berks County. I'm Crystal Seitz, and my co-chair, Kevin Barnhart, who usually joins me when we're producing this show, is out and about today doing actually an opening of a new business here in the area. So you got me. We're here today with two great men, two wonderful guys who are doing some really cool things for this spring that you'll be interested in. I have Eric Scarcella, from the Reading Fightin Phils. He's the Director of Public Relations and Communications. And I have Dan Clouser, who's the President of Big Vision, formerly known as Berkshire Baseball. So welcome, gentlemen.
Thanks for having us.
Thanks, Crystal.
I'm glad you're here. Our theme for today is Take Me Out to the Ball Game. And I know everybody here in Berks County is excited about baseball starting in the area, because that means spring is here. Hopefully the warm weather comes with it, and no snow and no rain. But also, it's just an exciting time because we get to be outside. We get to enjoy this all-American game. And, you know, we get to see minor league players and young, I don't want to say children, kids who
aspiring
to be minor league players. That's right. Get into the action and learn really good team play. And the hard work that it takes to be a baseball player, but also the responsibility and working with the team and why that's so important.
Right.
So I thought, take me out to the ball game. We wanted to, but with bad weather, we couldn't get out and shoot behind the scenes. But I don't think our viewers really get how much it takes to get ball fields ready and stadiums ready for the coming season. And I thought maybe we could talk a little bit about that. And you know, some of the things, you know, as we go through this, I know we're always very conversational. It's sort of like, hey, we'll just go with the flow about talking. But some of the things I thought about is, you know, I know there's things called, is it Dymatex? Dymatex that goes on the field, and there's certain ways you cut the grass, and there's the readying of things out there. I know Big Vision. At the Berks County fields, there's a lot of work being done to build the Green Monster. So maybe, Dan, we'll start with you. Tell us a little bit about what's happening out there on County Welfare Road.
All right. We've got a lot going on. Like Crystal said, we have Charlie Wagner Field, which will be a replica of Fenway Park. We've had a very tough winter, so our construction is a little bit behind schedule. We won't actually be playing on that field until later on in the month. We won't actually be opening up on that field, but we will be next weekend. We will be opening up on Rocky Calavito Field, Vic Wirtz Field, and Whitey Krowski Field. So we got a big opening weekend planned. Friday night, we're actually out at the Fightin Phils, being recognized out there as the neighborhood champions.
Good. Much deserved.
And, we've kind of got a close ties, so to speak, not really ties, but with the Boston Red Sox, so kind of playing in there where the Fightin Phils are opening up with the Portland Sea Dogs, which is Boston's AA affiliate, and kind of playing off the 2013 World Champions.
Absolutely.
And the Reading Red Sox affiliation from years back. So, you know, we were happy to take part of that. We'll be out there Friday night. With a table with some literature about our organization. And then Saturday, we open up. They've got a night game Saturday. We've got day games. We'll actually be doing some historic trolley rides on Saturday, which will include a behind-the-scenes tour. So, Crystal, if we didn't get the behind-the-scenes tour, they can jump on one of our trolley rides
right.
and get the behind the scenes tour of First Energy Stadium during one of our trolley rides. And then Sunday we've got a kind of premier trolley ride with Charlie Adams actually being the tour guide. It'll be a little bit more interactive, be a little longer. The ones on Saturday are only 90 minutes, and 30 minutes of that will be at First Energy Stadium. Sunday's tour will be a full 3-hour tour.
Wow.
Hopefully it works out better than what the Gilligan's boat ride
right.
turned out with Charlie there. But nonetheless, he'll be going to Lowers Park, 11th and Pike. The Fightins actually have a day game that day,
oh,
so there won't mm-hmm. be a tour of the stadium mm-hmm. that day, but still kind of a drive-by, and Charlie will talk about some of the history there. So we're excited, and we're excited to be partnering with the Fightins, kind of the amateur baseball organization, the professional organization, doing some co-branding, so to speak.
Absolutely. Yeah.
And how about you? What's happening out there?
Well, it's we're busy getting ready for the season right now. As I left to come over to the BCTV studios, we had a full operation staff prepping the stadium, making sure everything is prepped for this weekend. We kind of kick off, I guess we would call Fightin Phils opening week this weekend. So we have orientation, script run through things that we do, like all the contests on the field that people think, oh man, how do they do that?
Right.
Well, tomorrow's the day we kind of prepare and go through, try to get off the off season rust a little bit and get into in season mode. So we'll do that. And then the team gets into town this weekend.
Wow.
So our staff's really been busy about making sure their hotel arrangements are great, their bus arrangements. We've had it's been, like Dan said, a bearish winter.
Right.
So we are welcoming the season with open arms. We want the good weather. We want the spring. We want everything that goes along with it. It's baseball season. We're ready to celebrate.
Right. Well, good for you.
Yeah.
Let me ask the both of you. Maybe we'll start with you, Eric. How many people do you have working to get ready? Are you at 20 or 30
yeah.
or?
Well, we have a front office staff about 23 full-time front office people.
Wow.
So, they're doing anything from, coming to BCTV studios like myself to mm-hmm. promote the season. There's also, we have a sales staff that are busy, selling group tickets, yeah. season tickets, everything. And we also have, like our groundskeeper, our operations mm-hmm. staff. And it's, on top of that, we have, part-time help with our operations. We have a decent, pretty big stadium. So to paint it, to make sure, every nail is, hit, every screw is tightened.
Right.
It takes a lot of people. And we also have about 10 interns that, help us out with sales and do all sorts of stuff. So it's a pretty big undertaking. Getting the season going is, a really big part of our off season
yeah.
and part of our season. And once we get the season going, it's all fun and games from there.
Yeah.
We love welcoming everybody in Berks County out to come out to First Energy Stadium. It's a great time, and Reading Fightin Phils now, so you come see our ostriches.
Yeah.
We just got them here this week too,
that's
so that's
good.
Part of our stadium prep. Not usually normal, things that you do for baseball season, but
right. So it's part entertainment.
Part entertainment.
Besides the
business
the
and entertainment. Yeah,
yeah. I know. I like to watch the game, but most of the time I'm watching the people.
Oh yeah,
paying attention.
So, yeah,
to the
that's
game.
What my parents always say. They're like, they love it, but
yeah.
It's a good community meeting place too to see everyone. Like I said, we have Dan. They're coming out for our Friday
yeah,
game on
wonderful.
April 4th. So, Reading Red Sox celebration, Berkshire Red Sox, Boston Red Sox will be in town. So
yeah.
It's a little bit of a Red Sox night here.
All right. Well, that's good. Well, maybe if you wear your Red Sox, you get
yeah.
you get an extra hour on the field or something.
I'll have to
I don't
present
know.
That to Scott. We'll see.
And Dan, what about you? I know you have you're building your fields out there.
Yeah, our staff has grown quite a bit since January, where we've now got basically 8 front office staff members, and then a ground staff and maintenance staff of 5, mm-hmm. And we've got 4 fields that we're taking care of. They're not they don't have all the intricacies that First Energy
right,
Stadium
right.
has, but we still got signs that we got to make sure get up on the fences. We got to edge. We got to make sure the fields are ready for the kids to get
yeah.
out there and start playing. And then, yesterday is a prime example of everything that was going on out there, because we still have Farino finishing up the wall.
Yeah.
We have, HVAC guys in there getting stuff ready, the concession stand. We had Pepsi in there getting stuff ready for, the concession stand as well.
Mm-hmm.
We've got merchandise coming in every day. You know, so our director of concessions and merchandise is on his toes. We're, you know, every day we've got a shipment of 10, 20 boxes of whether it's souvenir cups or his peanut holders that are also megaphones and his frisbees that are also our, you know, platter trays and everything.
Oh, wow.
You know, and
a lot going on.
Necklaces and all kinds of stuff. So it's kind of, it's a little bit like Christmas right now when every day when UPS or FedEx shows up, we've got, you know, something new to look at and say, oh, this is cool. Now let's sell it.
Yeah.
You know, figure out if it does any good just sitting on the shelves at that point. So there's a lot of moving parts that, you know, whether coming to one of our games or coming to one of their games, you know, people don't realize what goes on. I mean, our guys right now are, you know, working 12, 14-hour days just to get stuff ready. You know, yesterday, they were, like I said, they were out edging Kurowski Field and getting that ready to go. You know, and then now today we got pretty much a lost day on the fields with the rain, and tomorrow is going to be a lot of the same. So, you know, it's you get a long day in and then you end up, you know, you get set back a little bit, but, you know, we keep plugging along. And if it's... you know, the great thing about the team that we put together is we've got an entire staff that is just on the same page about what we want to accomplish.
That's
so, you know, nobody, you know, if we need extra help with something, there's nobody who says, well, that's not part of my job.
Right.
Because we all wear so many different hats. And I think you guys are pretty much the same way.
Yeah.
And I'm sure you've pulled the tarp for dirt and stuff like
I've
that
done,
many times.
I've done a little bit of everything. Yeah. When you work for a baseball stadium, it's all hands on deck at any given moment. So,
that's sort of what makes it exciting, though, because you're not
always
doing
the
same thing.
No,
that's right.
That's absolutely true.
Yeah, I know. You know, it's funny because when you really think about all the different pieces that go into creating a ballpark and then putting the games on and the entertainment that goes with it, it's a lot. I mean, it's I don't know how you guys do it and do it in such a short period of time because, yeah, you've got your work during the winter months, but the real happenings are in the month before you open up, the chaos, you know, and the
organized
getting
chaos
ready.
Is what we call it.
Yeah.
And I'm sure Dan could kind of attest. It's like, as we get along here, you know, over the last couple of years, it hasn't really been, there really is no off season, for say. Like,
no.
You go, you're on, you know, as soon as you hit, you know, as soon as you kind of wrap up the season. We wrapped up the 2013 season, had about a month where we looked at all the numbers and we're like, all right, let's go sell.
How are we going to make it better?
We got to find out how are we going to do things this year? How are we going to make it, you know, interesting to our fans? So we're always thinking, you know, thinking forward, thinking about, you know, what we have going on. And it's just, I think, part of working in baseball season these days.
Yeah, it's the craziness. And I know, we'll start with you, Dan, because I know you have some other big things going on there. You're building the wall. Tell us about that.
Charlie Wagner Field, it's been quite an undertaking.
Yeah.
And again, part of what we're trying to do out there is to create, you know, a Berks County Baseball Museum, outdoor museum. And again, that's a large tie-in to, you know, to what the Fightins are doing is, you know, to be able to embrace that history that, that baseball has, you know, because we are in baseball town.
Right.
You know, so by naming all the fields and the walking paths, you know, we have Carl Farrell Way, we've got Dick Gernert Way, Rocky Santilli Way, and Paul Cooter Jones Way. Out there as well. So, you know, what we're trying to do is embrace the whole history of what Reading has to offer and what Berks County has to offer in the baseball community. And, you know, the thought process behind Charlie Wagner Field was, you know, with Charlie being a lifelong employee of the Boston Red Sox, we had an opportunity where we had a field that already had a natural bank in left field. So, you know, we came up with the idea. I mean, I knew Charlie personally, and one of the things that Charlie was very proud of is that he collected two paychecks his entire life, one from the Boston Red Sox and one from the United States military. And that was really the one thing that he was probably most proud of, is that from a player to a scout, pitching coach, you know, he was proud of his affiliation with the Boston Red Sox. So to be able to build a replica of Fenway Park in his honor was a huge way to kind of preserve his legacy. So, you know, at First Energy Stadium, they got Broadway Charlie Wagner Press Box, and we have, you know, Charlie Wagner Field. So that's kind of the tie-in of our trolley tour the first weekend, too, is that we're going from, you know, Charlie Wagner Field to, you can actually see Charlie Wagner Press Box.
Right.
You know, because Charlie was a huge, huge stellar.
I'm sorry to interrupt you.
Community.
Yes,
not
finish
a problem.
That up. Finish that
not
up.
A problem.
But when we come back, I want to hear more about how big, how high, how many bricks. Maybe you don't know. I know some of it's cement. But We'll be right back. We're going to take a break and join you in a few seconds.
You're watching bctv.org. Be informed, be involved, be a member. For membership information, go to www.bctv.org/support/membership. For other stories and information, go to bctv.org.
Around Berks County on BCTV is supported by Weidenhammer Systems Corp.
Welcome to Around Berks County. We're back. I'm sorry I had to interrupt Dan there for a second because we needed to take a break. But I asked him about the Green Monster, the big wall, and he's telling us a little bit more about Charlie Wagner and the inspiration for the wall, but also what does it look like, Dan?
Our wall, the bottom 13 feet of it, is a poured concrete retaining wall, yeah. And it's 20 inches thick. So
wow.
I mean, it's a massive.
So it's not going anywhere.
No. when we poured the concrete for that wall, they did it in one pour. Originally, yeah. We were going to do it in pieces, but because of the weather, we had a three-day window of good weather, and they decided, all right, we're going to do it in one pour. And we had 18 concrete trucks that rolled into the facility that day.
Wow.
So it was pretty, and we had a parade of
yeah.
concrete trucks,
yeah.
And it was pretty cool to see that happening. And for us, it was kind of a milestone because it was like all winter long. It was like, okay, we should be ready to pour next week. Oh, 6 inches of snow. Oh, we'll be able to pour next. Oh, 9 inches of snow. Oh, we'll be able to pour
so
next
it
week.
Really
oh,
was.
3 more inches of snow and 12 degree temperatures all week. So,
yeah.
The guys from Farina were incredible that they kept working through that weather and doing everything we could. I mean, the footer of this wall is 13 feet wide by 3 feet deep. And then, like I said, it's 20 inches thick. The total height of the wall will be 30 feet high as opposed to 37 feet high, like
wow.
the real Fenway Park. So we had 13 feet of concrete and then another 17 feet that'll be steel covered with a plastic sheet material. And the steel beams are actually being set on Monday. So we've got a crane coming in Monday. We'll definitely have some YouTube videos and stuff
yeah,
of that when that's
YouTube
going on.
It, yeah.
We've been able to document every, pretty much a weekly progress as this thing's been going on, which is actually pretty cool to see
yeah.
from when it was still a hill to when it was just
taking a shape.
Hole to everything else.
Yeah.
So we have been pretty diligent in being able to document how things have progressed, which is pretty neat. So the real Fenway Park is 310 feet down the line in left field. We'll actually end up being somewhere between 280 and 285. It's not quite as deep as Fenway, and again, 7 feet shorter.
Mm-hmm.
Center field for us will only be 350, but we'll have a 16-foot high fence out there. Fenway is a 17, and the footprint of the ballpark is pretty much spot on from the way we were able to do it. We'll have our own little version of pesky pole in right field, and for anyone who's a Red Sox fan, they'll be familiar with the red seat that's in right field, which is in Fenway, is where Ted Williams hit the furthest home run in Red Sox history, Fenway Park history. Off of our walking path, we're going to have a single red seat. Won't be the same distance as Ted Williams' home run. It'll kind of be to signify that Ted Williams and Charlie Wagner were roommates. We'll have a little plaque there explaining that Ted and Charlie were roommates. So. We're excited about it.
Very exciting.
It's really cool.
I can't wait to drive out there and just see.
Yeah, it's every day,
it's
like I
awesome.
Said, you go up there and see the progress that's
awesome.
Being done on it, and it's very cool.
Yeah.
So.
Sounds cool. So, what I want to say to our viewers is, hey, if you're out that way, you're off Country Welfare Road. County Welfare Road. Out towards Berksheim and the Berks Ag Center and Berks County Prison, you go out that way, look around. Maybe go out every week just to see what's happening and how it's growing.
Yeah, we're starting to get people who actually just come out to see the
what's
progress,
happening.
Which is
pretty cool. That's cool.
Yeah.
That is cool. Mm-hmm. So, and Eric, what's happening out there that's new and exciting
yeah.
we need to know about?
Well, over the last couple of years, if you haven't been out to the ballpark, we've had a major renovation, so I'm familiar with everything that you guys have
yeah.
going on over there.
Yeah.
2011, we had a major renovation. We've created the, now it's called Tompkins Vistbank Plaza, mm-hmm. so it's big. Then last season, you know, we had an All-Star game after that. Then this last season we had the rebranding, the ostriches, and we also added $1 million video board. So this year we're kind of, you know, we've delivered on the game experiences, we really enhanced it. Mm-hmm. This year we're kind of looking to add to that, but also on the promotional side, do things that we've never even done in, you know, in our history.
Yeah.
So there's some, we're doing a lot of bobblehead giveaways this year, which are always popular with people. Starting with opening night, we're doing a Chase Utley bobblehead. It's the first bobblehead we've ever given away wearing the new Fightin Phils uniform. So, he played here last year for a couple games as on a rehab appearance. We're also doing a first time ever bobblehead of Ryan Sandberg, a Hall of Famer, Chicago Cubs great, but now he's the Phillies manager. So he played in Reading in the early 80s. So it's a one way to tie that all history back in. But we're also doing bobbleheads of Dominic Brown, Cole Hamels, and then the big night, which is our Hall of Fame night, we're doing Jim Bunning, Hall of Famer, former senator from Kentucky. He'll be in town that night to be inducted into our Hall of Fame. He'll be signing autographs. He'll be doing all sorts of things because it's the 50th anniversary of his perfect game. So he'll be there. I think he'll be in Philadelphia as well.
It
should be a special night. So we're doing things that, you know, on the baseball, on the giveaway side, we might never have done ever before. And
right.
I think our fans, we've heard a pretty good response about those. On some other things, there's been some, you know, traveling acts that we have done. We had the Human Cannonball last year, and I don't know if any of you guys saw it, but it is something to be seen. David the Bullet Smith is his name. He shoots himself out of a cannon about 150 feet.
Oh, my gosh.
And you're like, oh, it's a guy shooting himself out of a cannon. I've never seen anything like it.
Yeah.
It's the one time, you know, win or lose, both teams were out of the dugouts, sitting there like all the kids and looking around. And they were all out there. You know, the coaches didn't seem to have a problem with it. And we're also doing an event. It's Cowboy Monkey Rodeo. I don't know if you've ever heard of it or seen it. It's kind of sweeping the nation in sports arenas. They've done the NFL, they've done the NBA, they do minor league baseball every summer, but the general gist of it is there's cowboys riding dogs herding sheep on the field.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So we have Team Ghost Rider coming in. It's a team of you know, little capuchin monkeys, and they ride dogs and they herd sheep. It's as crazy as it sounds.
Right.
We've never done it. People have been telling us for years, hey, you got to get them in, you got to do this. It's been on ESPN, it's all over the place.
Wow.
And we're like, you know, this is a first time thing. I think it's going to be one of our more popular nights here at the stadium.
Though. Yeah. I'm curious to see what that looks like myself.
Yeah, it's, you know, if you ever go on YouTube, you ever go on any online somewhere,
just look take up a cowboy look. Monkeys.
Yeah, and I know people like, purposely have told me like they don't want to see what it is because they kind of want to just be like take it all in that night of the event. So yeah, we're doing a lot on our promotional schedule is jam-packed this year, and you know, you could swing by, you know, local Wawa's, bars, restaurants, gas stations. Pocket schedules are out there.
Right.
Grab it. You can also go to fightins.com. Everything's up there as well.
Good. Thank you very
no
much
problem.
For that. And Dan, I want to sort of finish off. I have a couple events I want to go over, but I wanted to finish off because I know you've gone from Berkshire Baseball, formerly Berkshire Baseball, now to Big Vision Foundation.org. Mm-hmm. And just wanted to ask you, I know some of your reasonings behind doing that. Maybe you could share that with our audience of, you know, you're not just about baseball. And I think it's important that everyone understands that.
Yeah, I mean, that was part of our rebranding, was to make people understand that we are not just about baseball. I mean, baseball is, you know, still the heartbeat of our organization. I mean, I love baseball. Everyone on our staff loves baseball. And we love sports in general. But, you know, a bigger piece of that is really getting involved in the community. Mm-hmm. And, you know, as you know, we help with Cups Compassion that the Bureau's got us involved in for the past 3 years, where we go out and give away hamburgers and hot dogs for free on Penn Street a week before Christmas every year. We also, you know, always are collaborating with other nonprofit organizations, raising money for Keystone Warriors, Breast Cancer Support Services of Berks County, Children's Alopecia Project, and we're all, like I said, we're always looking for other nonprofits to collaborate with and to do stuff with. So it's, you know, like I said, baseball is always going to be a big part of our organization, but with what we're doing in that facility, outside of Charlie Wagner Field, we've got renovating the handicap adaptive trail, which has nothing to do with baseball, adding walking trails, refurbishing some of the soccer fields. And again, none of that has to do with baseball, but it has to do with actually just creating a beautiful facility for the community to kind of come out and just enjoy.
Right. So I think, and even in what that translates into is teaching the younger members of our community about community giving back, leadership, teamwork, again, responsibility, and, you know, strong work ethic. Yep. So I applaud you for that, because that all carries over into the rest of our lives, and we have to learn it somewhere. Sometimes we aren't able to learn it at home or at school, but when we're involved in something that we love, like baseball or soccer, it just seems to evolve naturally.
I got involved with it through my mother, who was kind of dragging me to concession stands to help, or Meals on Wheels, or whatever the case was. So it was just second nature for me to get involved in the community. And, you know, that's kind of the thought process behind, you know, to get them involved when they're young. It's not, you know, it's not like it's a chore to volunteer now.
It's fun.
So all those activities that we do, we get our players involved in, we get our youth involved in. So, I mean, they're out there with us for Cups of Compassion. They're out there, you know, wearing pink shirts and wearing camouflage shirts and helping do check presentations to these other organizations. And that, I think that really, really drives it home, is the importance of what it's like to give back to the community like that.
Yeah, well, good job.
Thank you.
Really good job. And I know the Fightin' Phils as well get involved with a lot of charitable organizations and support them. I know you've been a great help to Big Vision, you know, because you understand how important that is.
Yeah, we try to lend a hand to the community through Baseball Town Charities. It's kind of, you know, you could be a baseball team, you know, every day of the year, but to lend a hand to the, you know, inner city of Reading, to the local baseball community, it's something that, you know, we don't take for granted. We try to engage every year, and we'll be doing stuff throughout the season this year to keep doing that.
Well, good. We thank you for that well. We're almost out of time, so I just want to share with you a couple other great things that are happening. Well, of course, it's Jazz Fest. It's the Boscov's Berks Jazz Fest time. You want to find out what events are going on for Jazz Fest. There's a lot of free events out there. Go to gogreaterreading.com for any event going on in the community at any time. I know there's some special ones. April 5th, down at Hopewell Furnace, there is Jazz Fest concert to mark the 81st birthday of the Civilian Conservation Corps. So, free event. Head down there, participate, enjoy. It'll probably be outside, so you're going to have a lot of fun. Boone's Beer Fest is happening, too. Who would think that Daniel Boone would actually, well, or the Boone Homestead would actually allow you to drink beer on their property, but they have a beer festival that's craft beer that's wonderful. So if you get a chance, that's on April 5th. Head out. Again, it's outside. It's beautiful, but you've got opening games that day, so you got a lot going on April 5th here in Berks County. I understand we're out of time, so I say if you get a chance, check out gogreaterreading.com. Thank you, Eric. Thank you, Dan. Best wishes.
Thank you,
I hope it's a home run for both of you all year long.
So
fingers crossed.
Take care. Thanks again.
Around Berks County on BCTV is supported by Weidenhammer Systems Corp.